people are feeling a great deal of anxiety and fear and reservations about the future. At a time when people are going to work and don't know whether or not they will have a job when they get off. Look at your life right now. Whatever you've done up to this point in time, your life is working. Whatever you have produced, it came out of you as a result of the kind of person that you have become. It's a result of your choices. It's a result of your consciousness. Now you have to ask yourself, are you satisfied with what you have produced? Is this what you want? Would you like for things to be better than this? And if you don't know what it is that you showed up to do, if you don't know why you're here, I encourage you to find out what your purpose is here. What is the meaning of your life?
Which really stops certain people from being successful because they have so many barriers, so many obstacles to overcome that they never really get to success. Either they can't see it, or at some point they thought they saw it and they let somebody talk them out of seeing it.
It's a natural inclination for us to put ourselves down. See, we are born negative, I think, in a negative consciousness because we live in a negative world. Begin to guard your mind against negative programming, like turn off the television. Don't watch the news. Think that more people have a sense of hopelessness and anxiety about life. If you look at the news, you cannot feel good looking at the news. Don't pick up the newspaper and read it. No. Just try this. Just experiment with yourself. So you've got to guard the kinds of things that you put in your mind. See, if you don't program your mind will be programmed because human beings are goal-oriented. Where's all of this leading to? What's going on here? Most men live in quiet desperation. Most of us go through life running scared. That most people don't pursue their dreams, don't do better than what they're doing if they're capable of doing it. That the reason that we don't even explore the possibility of what to do is because subconsciously we don't believe that it can happen for us and we don't believe that we deserve it. How much time do you spend working on you? How much time do you spend every day working on your dream? In the last 90 days, how many books have you read? In the last year, what new skill or knowledge have you acquired? What kind of investment have you made in you? Fear kills dreams. Fear kills hope. Fear put people in the hospital. Fear can age you. Fear, ladies and gentlemen, can hold you back from doing something that you know within yourself that you're capable of doing, but it will paralyze you.
Success does not require you to look out the window. It only requires that you look in the mirror. The one person you need to be successful is looking right back at you. And if you're willing to make a commitment to that person in the mirror, if you're willing to look at that person in the mirror and say, I'll make a commitment to you from this day forward that whatever it takes, I'll do whatever it takes.
Listen to me. I'm here to tell you today that you can come here, you can jump up, you can do flips, you can be excited when we give away money. But listen to me, you will never be successful until I don't have to give you a dime to do what you do. You won't be successful until you say, I don't need that money. Some of you need to give up your cell phone because the time you spend on your cell phone could be used for your success. The time you could be using to be successful, you're using it on the sale. And the cell phone is not bringing you nothing but a bill. And I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want a party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep.
Or do you believe somewhere in the back of your mind or in your heart that there's some other great work for you to do? There's something else that life has for you. And that's why you're here. There's nothing to fear but fear itself. Start encouraging yourself. Start saying, I can do this. I can make this happen. Come on, man, get yourself together. You can handle this. You just haven't figured it out yet. It's all right. This is your training period. This is the tuition you have to pay for what you don't know. You can do this. Other people have done it. Doesn't take an Einstein. Get you some people that can teach you some stuff that you don't know. Get you some people that have done it successfully and learn from them. Take some seminars, workshops, read some books on how to manage a business. Change the way you see yourself and begin to tend to the personal details. Understand that nobody's going to take care of your business better than you. Take the plunge. Go into action. And ladies and gentlemen, you will be surprised at how things will come together.